Hello friends, welcome to Inside Text. This is a platform to learn about power transmission elements and its control system. So friends, in today's video, we have come here with a very new topic, very exciting topic, that is the circuit breaker. And specifically today, we are going to see its trip circuit supervision, local remote, closing and tripping interlocks of the circuit breaker. So friends, as you can see over here, we have today the control wiring connections inside the circuit breaker and how these connections are connected to the panel in the control room. So the first thing that you can see over here is J1 and J2. J1 and J2 is the DC supply of the connection. Next is the MCB. That is how J1 and J2 is connected into the control wiring. From this, we have the TNC switch, that is tripping and closing switch. Next, we are having this SF6 gas filling gauge, which indicates how much amount of gas is filled, SF6 gas is filled inside the circuit breaker. And through this gauge, there is connected a contactor. This contactor is operated whenever there is gas is filled inside the circuit breaker and also whenever it will have the DC supply. So next we are going to see there are few contacts of this contactor, that is 63AGX. We call it as GLX contacts, that are used as an interlocks for the closing and tripping circuit of the circuit breaker. So you can see over here, this is a LR switch, that is a local and a remote switch. We will understand in detail how this operates. Before that, let us understand about the closing circuit of the circuit breaker. As discussed, GLX is one of the contacts of this contactor. Next, there is a contact called as that is dedicated for the spring charging of the circuit breaker. This contact opens or close whenever as or when the spring is charged or discharged. Next, there are auxiliary contacts of the circuit breaker, that is 52A and 52B, that are used as for while the closing and tripping operations are done in the breaker. Then there is a closing coil. Closing coil is operated whenever we want to close the circuit breaker. All these things consist of the closing circuit of a circuit breaker. Now moving on towards the tripping circuit. Again over here we have GLX contact, then a auxiliary contact. Here we have two auxiliary contacts, 52A and 52B. Okay, and there is a trip coil. So what is the use of 52A and 52B is whenever the breaker is closed, okay, so 52B will remain closed, and due to which we can get a closed indication. The breaker is in open condition, so the 52B is closed right now. Also, the auxiliary contacts 52A and 52B are used for indication a circuit to indicate whether the circuit breaker is on or off. Now let us understand the panel of the what parts of the controlling are used inside the panel for the circuit breaker. The very first one is the TNC, that is trip and close switch, through which from the control room we can either trip or close the circuit breaker. And next is the relay. This is a master relay contact that is used for the tripping and closing of the circuit breaker. And the very important part now is the trip circuit supervision relay. This relay has two coils, basically A and B. Both are connected to the coil C. Now the B coil is used whenever the breaker is open. So it is used as a pre-close supervision because the breaker is open right now. So through 52B, we can get this contact of the supervision B, and due to which the C coil will also be operated. Now let us see the gas filling is done inside the circuit breaker. See, the gas is being filled and the contact is closed. Okay, so now let us understand what happens when we switch on this MCB and provide DC supply to our circuit breaker. See, what has happened is when we have turned on this MCB, the contactor has operated because the SF6 gas is filled. Due to this contactor 63AGX, its contacts GLX has now closed. Another thing that has happened is you can see that due to this, due to closing of this GLX contact, the breaker is open and we can now see the pre-closed supervision is done over here. And also due to closing of this 52B, there is indication of the breaker is off. Now what happens is another contact, that is of spring charge, will be closed when the spring gets charged. Okay. So now let's do the spring charge, and once the spring is charged, the indication of spring charge is also over here and these contacts are closed. So now let us understand another important part of the breaker, that is the local and remote switch. When the switch is connected into the local mode, it gets connected to the TNC switch inside the circuit breaker and it gets operated locally from the TNC switch. Also, whenever the local mode is operated, the breaker can always trip in the protection mode also, right? And then there is another aspect. Remote, whenever it is connected into the remote mode, the switch is connected through the panel TNC switch, so you can operate the circuit breaker remotely inside the control room from the panel. So right now we have the breaker in the off mode, remote and local switch is on the remote mode. So we are going to operate the circuit breaker from the control panel through the TNC switch. Let us operate the TNC switch. Now once the TNC switch is operated, the closing coil is operated, due to which all the contacts will now change and we have the post-close and supervision indication, and the spring is once again charged and then we get the spring charge indication back. Now let us once again see what happens when the circuit breaker is operated. See, the TNC switch is operated, closing coil is operated, post-close indication is there, contacts change, spring charge occurs, and we have the spring charge indication back. So this is the complete working operation of a circuit breaker. Friends, I hope you understood the working principle of the circuit breaker and its control wiring. Now, in the next video, please comment what you want to learn, or do you want to learn in more detail about the circuit breaker itself. Please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.